Mr. Vanan, a member of Managing Committee, Headmistress, Judges, Parents and my dear friends. So today we have gathered in this Zoom platform for final round of English Elocution Competition. But before we proceed further, we'll begin our program with a short prayer by Juhi Nair.
Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha, Saraswati Namastubhyam, Varde Kama Rupini, Vidyarambhu Karishyami, Siddhira Bhavatu Me Sada, Padma Panna Vishalakshi, Padma Kesara Varnini, Nityam Padma Laya Devi, Samam Patu Saraswati.
Thank you so much, Julie. This is the first virtual English Elocution Competition in history of our school, which is completely conducted with social distancing norms due to COVID-19 pandemic. Every child is posed to innate talents, some in writing and some in speech. And to judge this competition, we have two judges. Mrs. Vijay Sunita teacher, who is a master in literature, master in education and master in history. And Mrs. Janvi Prabhu teacher, who is a master in history, bachelor in education and also LLB. We welcome you both, ma'am, and it's a pleasure to have you. Kindly note, from each division, 3 students are selected. Only from one division, 4 students are selected. It means from 9th and 10th standard, altogether 25 participants are selected. Each participant has been given their contestant number. Time limit for your English elocution will be 3 minutes. Marks will be given out of 30. 10 marks for your presentation, 10 marks for your content and 10 marks for your pronunciation and flow of speech.
From 9th B, roll number 61. I'm here to share my views on how India can overcome COVID-19. The disease coronavirus, which is also known as COVID-19, has rapidly spread across the world with numerous cases and many life loss. Let's start from the beginning. All the story started somewhere in March and whole year changed from this month itself. India, which was second largest population in the world, has faced and is facing many difficulties due to this pandemic. As India's economy is at its base, people are feeling suffocated by living at their own house. It's strange but true. Also, each and every person is now facing financial problems. In fact, we can keep counting, but there we have a time limit, so we'll move on. Firstly, let me clear that this is not a very first year pandemic our India is facing, as we have faced and overcome many diseases like SARS, MERS, swine flu, etc. As we have overcome this disease, we can overcome COVID too. But one thing which is very important to overcome this situation is the oneness we need. If we have togetherness, yeah, then COVID is not a big deal for us. You see, for overcoming this COVID, government is providing us so many precautions and guidelines to be followed. If we follow that guidelines, it will definitely help us. Wash your hands often, coughing, sneezing on your bent elbow, not your hands. And for the information you can get whenever you make a call, right? But remember, a positive vibe, a positive thought, a positive attitude and a positive pose can change our perspective towards everything. So let's keep our promises towards our country and do our responsibility at our best. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.
And my topic for today is nepotism in Bollywood. Bollywood, no doubt, in last few years has taken itself to totally different level. The craze for Bollywood movie all across the globe is insane, and as Indians, we are really proud of it, as the hitters of Bollywood industry having today. But there is one such topic that cripple in Bollywood is nepotism. In simple parlance, nepotism means biased favoritism granted to relatives in various fields like politics, business, entertainment and various other streams. But This industry of Bollywood has been affected by this concept of nepotism more than any other industry, and probably is having more negative impact than positive in life. It is indeed a bitter truth that the seeds of nepotism are now barely growing to big trees. Actors with pure talent are sidelined as the full priority is given to relatives and favorites. And the worst part is, if an outsider tries to raise their voice, either they are suppressed or treated with ill or bad comments. If a star can get his or her first picture because of his family's fame, then it is nepotism. But even after his or her first picture, if he or she is getting more pictures because of his talent, then it is not nepotism. The only way to end nepotism, not only in Bollywood, in other streams too, the head's first priority should not be choosing his or her relatives, but it should be choosing talented people. This is my own point of view to end nepotism. But, as we all know, nepotism can't be ended, cause we all want our relatives to shine rather than anyone else. Don't you think? Thank you.
And my dear friends, today I am going to say few words on topic nepotism in Bollywood. Bollywood, no doubt, in the last few years has taken itself to a different level. The craze for a Bollywood movie all across the globe is insane, and as Indians we are really proud of the status Bollywood industry is having today. No one ever imagined when it started almost 100 years ago. But there is one such thing that has crippled into Bollywood in recent 20 years and has also been a hot topic of debate ever since it has existence. This is none other than the topic of nepotism. What is nepotism? Nepotism can be defined as act of using power and influence unethically to get the near and dear ones a good work or a good job. Nepotism in Bollywood is not a new phenomenon. It has become a talking point in the country. Today we talk about nepotism, and yes, nepotism stops new talent. Ever since Karan Johar was called flag bearer of nepotism on his famous talk show by actress Kangana Ranaut, it is indeed a bitter truth of Bollywood that the seeds of nepotism have now really grown into big trees. Actors with pure talent are sidelined as first priorities are given to favorites and relatives. The topic of nepotism not only exists in Bollywood industry, it is actually omnipresent in each and every sphere of work life. But this industry of Bollywood has been affected by this concept of nepotism more than any other industry, and it has now really reached to a toxic level in Bollywood. Thank you.
Good afternoon, my respected teacher. Today, I would like to speak on a very important and currently trending topic, viz. Digital transformation, need of the hour. First of all, we must understand what is digital transformation. Well, let me explain that. Digital transformation is the adoption of digital technology to transform services or businesses through replacing manual processes with digital processes. As we know that, industrialization and globalization were the principal aspects in the ending of the 20th century and beginning of the 21st. So, since the last decades, digitalization has become a comparatively much salient facet. And after the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic, digitalization became the paramount aspect. After the pandemic outbreak, everything, including trade, industries, and even the normal movement of common masses, came to a sudden standstill. Due to the restrictions imposed because of the lockdown, every sector was affected very badly. Let it be education, trade, government, private, or even small, medium, or large industries. So, as to begin again, in the midst of the ongoing pandemic, the only option was the use of digital technology. Hence, for this purpose, digitalization became the need of the hour. Consequently, India is digitally transforming on a very high pace. We have developed many digital platforms for carrying out our work digitally. For example, Bheem UPI for online transactions and payments. Various video conferencing apps, especially used by education and industrial institutions, and many more. All these digital platforms help us to carry out our work from anywhere around the globe without any physical contact. So, I would like to conclude by saying that still, we have much more to transform, as digital transformation is the need of the hour. Thank you.
Digital transformation, need of an hour. Technology serves a variety of purposes and means different things to different people. In today's world, technology can be found at every corner, from the local convenience store to our very own houses. Technology makes the world function more efficiently. There's no debating that technology has become integral in our daily lives. Digital transformation is the adoption of digital technology to transform services or businesses through replacing non-digital or manual processes with digital processes, or replacing older digital technology with newer digital technology. Digital solutions may enable new types of innovation and creativity in addition to efficiency via automation, rather than simply enhancing and supporting traditional methods. But why is digital transformation necessary? Well, embracing innovative digital technologies will not just benefit businesses, but will also be vital for future success. Digital transformation in the public sector and the government has numerous benefits for the country and its citizens, increasing efficiency and transparency, improving and aligning processes, smart government and smart cities, bridging the digital divide, data-driven government, enhancing citizen satisfaction and trust, meeting the needs of changing demographics, and balancing costs while optimizing efficiency. It all plays a role in the ongoing digitization and digital transformation of government and the public sector. After all, it is safe to assume that digital transformation is the need of an hour. Thank you.
And boys and girls of all ages present here. Myself, Priyansa here of Standard 10T, would like to express my views on the topic Nepotism in Bollywood, the unending saga of mediocrity and favoritism. Well, what do you mean by nepotism? Nepotism means the practice among those with power or influence of favoring relatives or friends. Nepotism in India, that's not a new problem. By the way, have you read Mahabharata? Eklavya and Karna were also the victims of dirty nepotism. And now, nepotism in Bollywood, the unending saga of mediocrity and favoritism. Nepotism in Bollywood is not a new phenomenon. It has just become a hot topic for debate and debated at almost every event. Many celebs from Bollywood industry feels that it's unfair on outsiders who are genuinely talented and more deserving. But nepotism exists everywhere. It's not just restricted to Bollywood. Filmmakers, scriptwriters, lyricists, music composers, and so on, who do an equally commendable job in movie making, are often overshadowed by on-screen performers. Why? Because the audience only want to see their renowned faces, not the people who had done lots of hard works behind them. Satyajit Ray has truly said that Indian audience doesn't have any respect for crafts and aesthetics. Not just Twitter hashtags and Facebook trolling, but there should be a sustained evolution that encourages path-breaking experimental storytelling and filmmaking. Nepotism isn't going to end. It is up to the audience to appreciate crafts and aesthetics if they actually want to avoid the dreadful fate of young artists. Only the audience has the ability to honor artists. It is up to the audience to choose the correct. If the audience doesn't change their perspective towards arts even now, then all the justice hashtags and social activism would be irrelevant. Let's just not complain about nepotism, but support worthy talents. And that's what I want to say. Thank you.
Now it's my pleasant duty to propose a vote of thanks. On behalf of Chembur Karnataka High School and Junior College, I express my sincere gratitude to our members of committee, judges, headmistress, parents, and all the participants for sparing your valuable time with us this evening in our English elocution competition. Thank you, one and all. Thank you so much.